Hello students, now today we are going to discuss about the relation between torque and angular momentum. As we know, torque that is equal to R cross F means cross product of position vector and force will provide torque, and angular momentum L is equal to R cross P, that is cross product of position vector and linear momentum will provide angular momentum along z axis. If particle move in anticlockwise, then angular momentum as well as torque we will get positive z axis. If particle move in clockwise, the angular momentum as well as torque we will get along negative z axis. Now in this module number 4th, we will discuss about relation between torque and angular momentum. Therefore we know that angular momentum L that is equal to R cross P, equation number 1. Differentiating equation number 1 with respect to T on both sides. Differentiating equation 1 with respect to T both sides. We will get dl divided by dt that is equal to first function as it is derivative of second function r cross dt divided by dt plus first function as it is derivative of second function dr divided by. As we know, dr by dt, dr divided by dt, that is equal to velocity. dp divided by dt, that is rate of change of angular momentum, that is applied force according to Newton's second law. So, rate of change of angular momentum, that is force. Now, dl divided by dt that is equal to r cross f plus p linear momentum multiplied by velocity. Here linear momentum can be written as p that is equal to m into v, p that is equal to m into v. Therefore r cross f plus m v cross v. Now r cross f plus m v cross v, cross product of two equal vector, that is 0. Therefore dl divided by dt that is equal to r cross f, as r cross f that is torque. dl divided by dt that is equal to torque. dl divided by dt that is torque. We can see that rate of change of angular momentum that is equal to torque. Now next one is moment of inertia. Moment of inertia. As mass play role in straight line motion. As we know, moment of inertia plays same role in the rotation motion. When a body moves along straight line, then mass of the body will oppose the motion along straight line, that is called inertia. It is inability of a body to change itself along straight line motion, that is called inertia. Same as when a body moves along circular path, then moment of inertia will oppose the tendency to change the state of the body, that is called moment of inertia. So we have to find out moment of inertia of a rigid body. Let us consider rigid body. This is the axis of rotation, x, x dash. This is the first particle having mass m1, distance r1. Second particle having mass m2, distance r2. Third particle having mass m3, distance r3. Or last particles having mass m and distance r. Let us consider a body. Consider a body consisting of n particles. Consider a body consisting of n particles. Having mass is m1, m2, m3, m, situated at a distance, situated at r1, r2, r3, rn respectively. Then moment of inertia. Moment of inertia of rigid body. I is equal to m1 r1 square plus m2 r2 square plus mn r square. This can be written as summation I is equal to 1 to n mi ri square. If mass distribution is uniform and continuous, then moment of inertia I, that is equal to r square dm. Unit of moment of inertia, unit dimensions, dimensional formula. Dimensions of mass m r l2. Unit nikalte, unit. Unit of mass kilogram, unit of distance meter square. CGC nikalte gram centimeter square. Gram centimeter square. Physical significance. Physical significance of moment of inertia. Physical significance. First, moment of inertia depends upon mass of the body. Moment of inertia depends upon mass distribution. From axis of rotation. Second, shape of the body, shape and size. Third, distance from axis of rotation. Distance from axis of rotation. All these factors that all these factors are responsible for change in moment of inertia from one body to another body. Next one is radius of gyration. Radius of gyration. Let us consider rigid body consisting of n particles having each particle of mass m situated at a distance r1, r2, r3, rn from the axis of rotation x, x dash. Let us consider rigid body consisting of n particles having each particles of mass m situated at a distance r1, r2, r3, rn from the axis of rotation. Let center of mass of this body, center of mass means total mass of this body is at a distance k from the axis of rotation x, x dash. From the axis of rotation x, x dash. Now we will find out moment of inertia of this rigid body. Moment of inertia. Moment of inertia. I that is equal to first particle mass m square of distance r square plus second particle mass r2 square plus nth particle mass m multiplied by n r n square. Now m taking out common r1 square plus r2 square plus rn square. Equation 1, multiplying and dividing by m in right hand side. Equation 1, multiplying and dividing by m in right hand side. I is equal to m into n, r1 square plus r2 square plus rn square divided by n. M into n, mass of particle multiplied by number of particles. M into n, total mass of particle. This calculated as now there is alternative methods to find moment of inertia. Total mass of the body capital M, distance from the axis of rotation k. We have to calculate moment of inertia from these points. Moment of inertia I that is equal to mass, total mass multiplied by k square. From equation number 2nd and 3rd, from equation 2nd and 3rd, we get, or we can say that putting the value of I from equation number third to equation number second. Therefore, mt square that is equal to m r1 square plus r2 square plus rn square divided by n. So capital N we cancel out, we get k is equal to r1 square plus r2 square plus rn square divided by n. Radius of variation k is equal to root mean square of distances from the axis of rotation. Radius of variation is equal to root mean square of distances axis of root mean square of distances from the axis of rotation. Thank you. Have a nice day. Please stay tuned for module number 3.